Government ministers assembled at Downing Street for emergency talks on whether to approve taking part in an attack on Syria. The Prime Minister said she believed the Syrian regime was to blame for the poisoning of its people. The international community, she said, must respond. And for the UK, that means joining a US-led coalition against President Assad. Theresa May suggested she's willing to make that move without a vote in Parliament. The government's allowed to take military action without parliamentary backing, but in the past 15 years, successive governments have run major military plans past the House of Commons first. In 2013, Theresa May's predecessor, the then Prime Minister David Cameron, put his case for intervening in Syria in front of Parliament, where it was defeated, a huge blow for him and his government. This time, Theresa May can't risk losing control of her defence and foreign policy plans. But opposition politicians say Parliament must be consulted.
There has to be a proper process of consultation. We elect Parliament, we elect members of Parliament, they should have a voice in this. The Cabinet on its own should not be making this decision.
Theresa May needs to get this right. Tony Blair's decision to invade Iraq in 2003 cast a long shadow over British politics. The invasion was later found to be based on flawed intelligence. Members of Theresa May's own party are worried it might be too late to get involved.
The moment's passed because 5 years ago, Assad was in a weak position and was vulnerable to Western bombing. The Russians weren't there, and there were moderates in the Syrian opposition. There aren't any more. The situation has changed.
We're having a meeting. The US president is waging war on Twitter, threatening Assad and his ally, Russia. The British government will need to calibrate its response in more measured tones. Niamh Barker, Al Jazeera, London.